What is going on, everybody? It's your boy Ahiazokin. Welcome back to the channel. We're gonna ask the question, would you snitch to save your life? So watching and reading up on Tekashi 6ix9ine's story made me contemplate this question for a couple days. Would you snitch to save your life? If I had to answer the question, I don't know. There's a lot of factors you gotta consider when it comes to snitching. I think snitching is more of a street term than it is a more of a general everyday people term. Like, a lot of street terms get incorporated into like general slang. So is snitching, it gets very murky and very gray. Would you call whistleblowing snitching? Let's say somebody robbed your house and you know who it was. Would you declare it snitching if you told the police who you think robbed you? With Tekashi 6ix9ine, he got hit with racketeering charges and 8 or 9 other charges. He had a decision to make. When it comes to Tekashi 6ix9ine, I'm gonna have to side with him on this one. I know this is an unpopular opinion, but hear me out. I'm not trying to say that 6ix9ine was right in ratting on people who protected him before he got sent to prison. Like, for instance, him ratting on Shadi, the guy who he told to go put a hit on Chief Keef, that was wrong, and that doesn't slide in my book. And everybody wants to talk about snitching and loyalty and how he ratted on his whole gang, or at least the gang he was affiliated with. He wasn't being loyal to them. Now ask the question, what do you mean by loyalty there? I feel that there was no loyalty to begin with. So Daniel Fernandez, Tekashi 6ix9ine's real name, he basically said that Tekashi 6ix9ine was a character he was portraying who was promoting more gang violence, but it was all an act, that's not the real Daniel Fernandez. So when 6ix9ine approached Treyway, it wasn't so much out of loyalty, it was just out of clout. So it's more of like a symbiotic relationship there, where Tekashi would use them to make him seem like he was a hard blood member, and Treyway would be cashing checks off him. But then when charges started to come on to 6ix9ine, 6ix9ine started distancing himself from Treyway, and that's when a lot of things started occurring. You have members threatening to kidnap his mom. You have gang members messing around with his baby mom. Some members even kidnapped him and tried extorting him for money. There's a lot of things to build up. If you want to talk about loyalty, Treyway wasn't really loyal to 6ix9ine, and 6ix9ine was never really loyal to Treyway. At that point, I felt like Tekashi had to do anything he had to do to reduce his sentence and at least get away somewhat scot-free. And when you're thinking about things like, oh, I may actually go to prison, you're gonna do everything you can to not go to prison. Does he say F you to the judge and not give any information and could face at least 47 years in prison? Or does he snitch, reduces his charges, and tell the judge and give the judge all the information they need while reducing his own sentence because he's thinking about his family first? He may be the sole breadwinner of his family. So you have to think, are you loyal to gang members who did all these things to you? Or are you loyal to your actual family who've been there and love you and care about you? Would y'all do the same thing that 6ix9ine did? A lot of y'all have a lot of things going on in your lives where you can't just go to jail for just to save somebody you know. I'm an average guy, not a gang member. If I got caught up in something where if I have no personal relations with the people I get caught up in or act with, I'm not gonna jeopardize myself. So there's a lot of factors that go into the snitching. I feel like we need a proper definition of snitching when it comes to the general public. When it comes to the streets, obviously snitching is a no-go, and I get that. I just find it ironic a lot of gang members talk about having codes when a lot of them don't even have codes. I'm gonna make a quick scenario right now. Let's say you're in a gang and you're with other gang members. You don't necessarily know. All you are affiliated to the same gang. So you guys are about to hit a lick together. That means to perform a robbery. You're gonna hit a lick with people in the gang. And after you guys hit the lick successfully, you get back a lot of cash or jewels or whatever. Because you have no personal relations with the gang members you just hit the lick with, what's to stop you from hitting a lick on them? Unfortunately, that's how it goes for a lot of gangs. You have a lot of internal warfare because people aren't loyal to each other. So we want to talk about loyalty. Where is the loyalty? So to me, I'm just talking for me personally, I feel like there's no codes in the street life. A lot of rappers, a lot of gang members want to talk about, oh, how they don't snitch on anybody, they have moral codes. They really don't. Obviously, there's a few exceptions, but the majority of them are going to look out for themselves first before anyone else. Back to general terms, would you snitch? Let's say somebody you care about and you love dearly, their life is at risk because somebody you know was planning to murder them. Would you snitch? I would. Let's say somebody you knew robbed you and the police came up to you asking for descriptions or if you want to press the charges. Would you snitch? I think you would. I understand there's a lot of factors that go into play for people feeling the need to snitch or not. And it all comes down to the question, who are you loyal to? But you know what? I'm gonna leave it for y'all to decide. Let me know in the comment section down below, would you snitch if you had to? Boom, what's up? Thank y'all for making it all the way to the end of the video. I greatly appreciate it. This was an interesting topic. Would you snitch to save your life? Let me know in the comment section down below. Honestly, I am destroying my reputation here, but that's okay. You can help me improve my reputation by hitting the subscribe button and tapping the bell notification. That way you never miss a video I upload. Tap that like button because it really helps and supports the channel. And if you have a question you want me to answer, make sure you hit me up in the comment section down below. Or you can hit me up in my social media handles down there too. DM me, I can get to a question in the next video. That is all I got for y'all today. Make sure y'all staying safe. And as always, easy.